Haydn Prime.
What if we lived in a world like this? A world where people can just sit back while the cars drive by themselves. A world where robots do the work for us. What if things became smart and could think for themselves? Would we be able to make this world a reality? The world that we dreamed of is already here. At the World Economic Forum that took place in Davos, Switzerland this year, the fourth annual Industrial Revolution was characterized as the age of extreme automation and connectivity. From 3D printers to the Internet of Things, biotechnology, autonomous transportation systems, and robotics, key technologies will converge and create new added value. We already have intelligent devices all around us, and various and new technologies are being developed and applied.
I think in terms of markets, you should think of energy. There's a tremendous potential for being much more energy efficient. Transportation, self-driving cars would fall into Internet of Things. You could think of hardcore industry, oil and gas, for example, where we now coordinate all of the devices to produce greater economic efficiency and greater safety.
The country that's seeing the fastest changes during this industrial revolution is China. By the 1980s, Shenzhen was already a designated special economic zone and started reaping in US dollars by producing electronic goods. And now it's rising as the heart of China's ICT industry. Shenzhen is home to the headquarters of DJI, the Apple of drones, Segway's new owner Ninebot, and ICT solution providers such as Huawei. Huachengde, a major electronics marketplace, is also located here. Shenzhen was once called the birthplace of China's copycat culture. But now, it's growing as a core strategic area for the fourth industrial revolution.
처음에는 해외에 있는 제조 단지로서 시작을 했지만 지금은 한마디로 말하면 아시아의 실리콘밸리가 될 확률이 가장 높은 편입니다. 이유는 인력, 돈, 제조 인프라가 다 몰려있기 때문이기도 하고요. 예를 들면 한국에서는 일주일 걸릴 수 있어요. 어떤 아이디어를 발주했을 때. 그러나 중국에서는 하루 만에 그 제품을 다음날 받아볼 수 있습니다. 이러한 역동성, 그리고 돈을 벌고자 하는 그런 의지들이 충만한 곳이 선전이고요.
The secret behind China's extremely rapid growth is startup funding by big business accelerators. There are about 100 accelerators in Shenzhen. And Ingdan is the most representative one of them all.
你叫什么名字？我叫小萝卜，请多多关照。你今年几岁了？我三岁了。Ingdan
is an accelerator established in 2013 by Kogobai, a Hong Kong-based e-commerce company with a market capitalization of over US $1.7 billion. Equipped with Shenzhen's good infrastructure and partnerships with over 10,000 companies, Ingdan has supported over 8,000 startup projects.
Ingdan is China's most intelligent technology startup platform. We provide intelligent technology innovators a one-stop service, from the idea to the production of the product, to the final production, including post-production marketing, sales and product sales. Actually, these are all Ingdan's main services.
Ingdan's motto, Hatch the Internet of Things. It has about 700 employees and branch offices in San Francisco, Milan, Hong Kong, and more. and it provides all essential services to entrepreneurs with hardware-based startup ideas. It also helps startup companies analyze, upgrade, distribute, and market their products through an evaluation group made up of 4.5 million advisors. It was this startup ecosystem of Shenzhen that enabled China to emerge as a world-class market in IoT, AI, and drones.
This is a 360度旋转，然后它这里有。 激光头可以发射激光，然后这边接收激光。事业成果这一块的话，首先，最近的话，因为是处在一个比较关键的一个时期嘛，就是我们一个产品化这个时期。通过应丹这个平台，我们还是就是能够非常快的加速了我们这个产品的一个进程，让我们就是能尽快的实现这个产品化，实现一个量产。
Shenzhen, the Silicon Valley of hardware. Here, high-tech startups with competitive power have been growing at a rapid rate. Its AI and robotics have advanced so quickly in recent years that it's startling the dominant powers, the US and Japan.
Open your eye. Shake your hand.
我觉得中国的机器人现在应该说跟欧美、跟日本还是有一定的差距，但是发展的速度非常快，在这个应该说整个的大环境对促成了这种发展吧，中国的整体的这种产业的升级，包括政府对这个产业的投入和带动作用，我觉得这个在这里面起了关键的一些促进作用。那大马拉说。
The Chinese government's entrepreneurship support policy also played a big role in successfully incubating startup businesses. It established over 1,200 advanced technology research institutes to actively promote the growth of new industrial fields, such as AI and robotics. Many accelerators are starting to invest in startups and acquire their shares. StarGeek in Shenzhen. It was established by Tencent's subsidiary Legend Star in 2014. Monthly rent for startups is only about $85 US. They can use expensive equipment such as 3D printers and create prototypes whenever they want. The result has been outstanding. Last year, 50 out of 70 startups were evaluated to be worth about $218 million. Sibichi, a developer of speech recognition software for automobiles, is a successful company now worth over $570 million.
那我们星云加速器呢，是成立于2014年。 到现在运行的话呢，是将一年半的时间，持续了有是专注于智能硬件和人工智能这样的一个专业领域。那其实大家可以看到，是一进门的时候有两个 logo， 两个名字了。那么联想之星呢，是联想控股集团，也就是大家所熟悉的 Lenovo 所属的这个集团，做早期投资 VC 方面的。那么从2012年开始的话，我们到现在投了将近100个项目。
Honda is another startup that became successful with Legend Star's incubation support. Honda specializes in iris recognition. In the age of the fourth industrial revolution, security is a major agenda. And the field of biometric recognition has been gaining steam. The company's future looks bright.
虹膜识别的这个方案解决商，在这个虹膜识别算法这一块来讲，我们一直追求就是遥遥领先。那么在应用这个层面上来讲，我们会加大这个力度，在这个各个应用场景上呢，能够给全世界的这种消费者带来这种虹膜识别的这种安全性、可靠性和便捷性的这种。
The accelerator played a decisive role in nurturing Honda from a small startup made of two people to a recognized company in the field of biometrics. China's startup market enables startups to collaborate with big businesses and combine their resources and technology. And that is the secret behind China's rapid growth as a world-class ICT powerhouse. Why is China investing extensively in startups? The answer is right here. Known as Apple of the drone world, DJI is at the forefront of the world market, ahead of the US and Japan, with its 74% market share. This company, however, was also once a startup created by two youths in their 20s. Now the company is worth over 127 billion US dollars, and it's grown at a steady rate of about 19% per year.
So, as we said, you know, this is the most intelligent drone that we've made. And these two eyes here actually are the sensors for the obstacle avoidance systems. Yeah, and as we said, you know, this one has a lot of intelligent features which you could actually control on the tablet of the DJI Go app. So you could do tap fly, you could do tracking, you could, you know, try the sport mode. It even has very simple one-touch buttons like auto landing, auto takeoff.
The key to its success was technology. It developed the TapFly feature for users who found controllers inconvenient. The response was explosive when it released a user-friendly app that allowed people to control their drones through tablets and smartphones.
So we started looking at how this technology could be used for different markets and industries late last year. We first introduced the Agris MG1, which is a pesticide spraying drone for the agricultural industry. So, and then we started to identify other sectors which the technology could be used. And now we've identified actually five.
Drones have a high market demand. They can spray pesticides over large areas and even carry out risky missions at dangerous sites, like the nuclear power plant. When there's a fire, drones can detect the direction of the fire and find the quickest route for firefighters. They enter disaster zones, search for survivors, and detect dangerous sites where further damage might occur. Outside that, drones have long been used in aerial filming of movies and broadcasts. Like this, the market for drones is growing, and the competition will only get more intense. That's why China's dominance in the market is significant. Premier Li Keqiang's Internet Plus plan brought great changes to China's industrial structure. China's largest electronics marketplace, Huaqiangbei. Recently, there has been a growing number of consumers looking for local brand products. Last year, there were over 1.1 billion smartphone users in China, and most of the phones were local brands. Chinese brands have reaped success by offering great functions at fair prices. And now, they are targeting young consumers with advanced multifunctional features. The most popular phones are ones that come with a fingerprint recognition system. Dongguan is a city located about an hour away from Shenzhen. Xiaomi is one of China's largest smartphone manufacturers. It also emerged as a new rival to global brands as its market share surpassed 20% in 5 European countries in just 1 year. In the first quarter of this year, Xiaomi became the 10th largest smartphone market shareholder in the world, along with ZTE. And last year, it caused global sensation by releasing the world's thinnest smartphone at the time, with its 5.15mm full metal frame with tempered glass. China isn't the only country to release products equipped with biometric authentication technology. Companies all over the world are doing it, but Xiaomi chose to collaborate with an already reputable biometric solutions company instead of developing its own technology. And in two of their latest products, they used biometric trackpad, or BTB, and increased product sales by adding a separate security chip and developing the world's most secure Android phone in existence. The manufacturer that boosted Xiaomi's sales was a small Korean company.
科大高科的指纹识别模块的识别速度快，并且准确，同时他们所采用的素材非常多样化，设计方面话也很强。与其他指纹供应商相比的话，他们不仅硬件方面技术过硬，也具备算法和分辨软件的技术。另外，服务也非常好，在开发的过程中，大家沟通和解决问题的速度更快。我们和科大高科从2013年开始合作。
A small Korean company that supplied most of the fingerprint identification modules in China. How did its technology succeed in the huge Chinese market? To find the answer, we visited the company located in Pangyo Techno Valley, the center of Korea's ICT industry. The very first place that greets us is the exhibition hall. This hall displays all the smartphones that use the company's security module. And since the latest trend in the smartphone market is biometric authentication modules, orders have been flooding in from all corners of the world.
Crucial Tech은 생체인식 장치의 핵심이라고 할 수 있는 센서 IC, 그 다음에 알고리즘, 모듈 패키징을 모두 다 자체 개발할 수 있는 세계 유일한 생체인식 원스톱 솔루션 기업입니다. 양산에 만족하지 않고 지속적인 R&D를 통해서 BTP의 기능을 개선하고 또 신제품을 개발하여 시장을 선도하고 있습니다.
A fingerprint sensor works by capturing a digital image of the fingerprint. Then this biometric template is later matched to confirm user identity. This convenient authentication method can be used to do everything from unlocking phones to making payments and providing security for credit cards. Currently, 60 companies worldwide are using their products. Now we can make transactions on smartphones. Fingerprint security modules have emerged as a core authentication method, and their success depends on how effectively they can block increasingly sophisticated hacking techniques.
기존의 이제 지문 센서들은 내 생체 정보인 그 지문 정보가 빠져나가게 되면은 그걸 복제해서 위조 지문을 만들어서 제 폰을 열 수 있는 그런 단점을 가지고 있거든요. 그런 단점들을 극복하기 위해서 제 지문 정보가 유출이 되더라도 위조 지문이 만들어지더라도 열 수 없는 그런 지문 센서를 만들려고 하고 있습니다.
The biometrics market is growing fast. To have competitive power, companies need new, stronger security technologies. This company succeeded in the global market by creating sub-miniature security modules. It created the world's first anti-fake BTB and shining BTB systems that can read and recognize fingerprints and heartbeats at the same time. This two-step verification method provides added security and can also be combined with other biosignals, such as pulse and bioimpedance.
이제 인간의 이제 생활사가 뭐 어쨌든 뭐 홍채든 만면이든 뭐 지문이든 다수의 어떤 뭐 보안 솔루션을 가지고 접근할 거고 이 생활 주변 생활 기기가 전부 다 이제 어떻게 보면 이제 외부로부터의 어떤 해킹을 방지하고 또 특정 내 삶의 어떤 영역을 구축하는 보안 솔루션 쪽으로 가지 않을까 이렇게 생각합니다.
There is another Korean company in Pangyo Techno Valley that successfully entered the Chinese market. And it did so by developing a copy protection chip and exporting it to 400 companies worldwide. 이거는 어떻게 된 거야? 이거는 There used to be about 1,000 semiconductor manufacturers in Korea. Now there are only three. This company started as a one-person startup. It develops a product known as intelligent semiconductor. And with this innovative item, it could successfully enter the counterfeit-filled Chinese market and grow rapidly.
현재까지 한 400여 개의 회사에 그 탑재가 되고 있고요. 대표적으로 뭐 블랙박스, 내비게이션, MP3 뭐 휴대폰 또 뭐 여러 가지 전제품. 그러니까 저희 전자 방석부터 전기 장판부터 인공위성까지 마이콤이 들어간 모든 종류의 전제품을 복제 방지할 수가 있습니다.
Cutting-edge technology is the game changer in this age. Startups with specialized skills have become big hits all over the world. However, how unfair would it be if someone copied the technology of another company? This is why the copy protection chip was developed.
IoT라고 해서 인터넷 오브 띵 그래서 모든 전자제품들이 인터넷에 연결되고 있습니다. 그래서 심장 박동기라든가 또 헬스케어 장비, 뭐 약을 주입하는 장비라든가 도어락, 또 뭐 가스 밸브, 뭐 집에 있는 뭐 전등까지 뭐 심지어 모든 것들이 다 인터넷에 연결되고 있는데 인터넷에 연결됐을 때 보안이 되지 않으면 굉장히 그 심각해지는 문제가 생기거든요. 예를 들어서 뭐 내 몸에 있는 심장 박동기가 해킹된다든가 이러면 죽을 수가 있는 거죠. 약물 주입도 과다 주입이 될 수가 있는 거고.
When manufacturing an electronic device, this copy protection chip must be built in for the finished product to function properly. Without it, counterfeits will malfunction. Each chip also comes with its own serial number, making it impossible to copy the chip itself. With its unrivaled technology, this company could make the smallest semiconductors and prevent illegal copying through hardware. Now the company sells more than 10 million chips a year as the only manufacturer of miniature intelligent semiconductors in the world.
예전에는 이제 국내가 뭐 한 80%, 뭐 해외가 20% 이 정도였었는데 최근에는 이제 중국에서도 서로 복제를 많이 하니까 중국이 한 80%, 한국이 20% 이 정도로 역전되고 있습니다. 중국이 더 많이 사용하고 있습니다.
China is well known for its Shanzhai or copycat culture. And because of this, more companies are beginning to look for copy protection chips. This DMR radio manufacturing company in Shenzhen also uses the Korean company's copy protection chip in its new devices. As a company specializing in communication devices, it prioritizes security in all its products. And the copy protection chip increased product value. Two-way radios manufactured here are supplied to public institutions throughout China. And they must be safe from hacking for public security bureaus, military units, hotels, fire departments, and other institutions to make emergency calls.
我们所做的这个 PDT 或者 DMR 的这个产品，它都带有内置加密，带加密卡槽。带加密卡槽的目的就是为了给客户留有今后对使用中进行语音和数据加密的作用。它的作用主要是为了为客户保证它语音数据通信方面的安全性。
This company could succeed because of the increasing demand in the Chinese market and lower production costs and prices achieved through the development of a tiny 1 square millimeter product.
기존의 외산 제품에 비해서 가격 경쟁력이나 성능 또 딜리버리 여러 가지 조건들이 굉장히 우수하고 전류 소모량이 작다 그리고 가격이 매우 저렴하다 이런 평가를 저희가 받고 있습니다.
Of course, the biggest change brought by the Fourth Industrial Revolution took place in China, and Shenzhen's rise has attracted global attention. Ever since it became China's major ICT hub, Shenzhen has hosted the International Internet of Things Expo every year. The Internet of Things, or IoT, is an expansive network of objects that applies to all areas of the Fourth Industrial Revolution. Everything around us will become data. The IoT is a network of physical objects that continuously exchange data through the internet, and it is being used in various fields. We now live in an age where devices that are connected to the internet can exchange information with each other without human intervention. They can freely communicate through Bluetooth, near-field communication, and sensors. Many Korean companies are making efforts to develop new IoT technologies, and about 10 Korean companies displayed their research results at this year's expo.
With Thing Plus, cities can now use real-time data to help improve residents' lives.
Yeah, 저희 Thing Plus 플랫폼의 가장 큰 장점은 누구나 쉽게 자신들의 디바이스를 클라우드 플랫폼으로 연결해서 쉽게 IoT 서비스를 구축할 수 있다는 게 제일 큰 장점이고요. 해외에서 저희가 가장 주목을 받게 된 가장 큰 이유도 누구나 쉽게 IoT 서비스를 만들 수 있다는 게 가장 큰 장점이고요. 글로벌 여러 기업들과 협업을 하고 있습니다. 예를 들어서 시스코라든지 델, 그다음에 퀄컴, 리벨륨과 같은 글로벌 기업들하고 협업을 통해서 저희 시장들을 점점 넓혀가고 있습니다.
The Korean company that dominated China's electronics market with its copy protection chip also received much attention. For startups, expos are a good way to enter foreign markets because people in related fields come from all around the world. This company also entered the Chinese market through an expo.
在一些个人的隐私呀，或者在一些比较重要的一些数据的保存上，都存在一些安全问题。那么这个芯片呢，它是双加密的，需要有身份认证的一个功能，所以我觉得这一点还是很好的。Who
could have predicted China's remarkable growth? China's Internet Plus action plan came at the perfect time for the Fourth Industrial Revolution. And China could join the ranks of technologically advanced countries by encouraging accelerators to incubate startups. Ch- changes have been happening at a much faster pace than ever. Everything is being interconnected and new technologies are emerging. Accordingly, human life is starting to change in unprecedented ways. Who will lead future technology?
It will be automated and it will become more efficient. So there will be many things that are done by people will be done by machines, by talking to each other. For now, there are many machines in each plant, and each machine is talking to a person. There is a person who is controlling this machine. And I guess what will be happening in these revolutions that machines will be talking to each other without a human intermediary. So this actually will create tremendous wealth because it will improve productivity of the manufacturing.
How has the fourth industrial revolution affected Silicon Valley? Companies are researching core technologies of the future and ways to commercialize them. And there is one startup here that became famous with its achievements in AI. Evolution of machines. This is the core characteristic of the fourth industrial revolution. Machines can now think for themselves and do people's work. This company developed an AI lawyer called Ross and shocked the world with its ability to provide legal information.
What we've done with Ross and what you're seeing is the ability to ask your question to Ross, not using keywords, not using any special language, communicating to it as you would another lawyer. And what Ross does for you is all that heavy lifting. It reads through and understands millions of cases a second. It then shows you not only the cases you need, but the direct passages from those cases that answer your question.
What is the difference between setoff and recoupment in Arizona and the Southern District of New York? And then I'll scroll. Yes.
Ross can't argue a case in court, but it can save a lawyer from investing hours and hours into reading cases. It uses data analysis technology to find relevant case studies so that lawyers can work as efficiently as possible. In other words, Ross is the smartest secretary a lawyer could wish for. Ross uses machine learning technology to stay up to date. As it continues to learn, it collects more data and evolves into a smarter software.
The future for Ross Intelligence is to be in every legal market in the world. We want Ross to be helping lawyers in Korea. We want Ross to be helping lawyers in Canada, where we started, and in every country in the world. And we're going to continue to build out various systems that help lawyers do as much as they can and be as efficient as possible.
Through Lee Sedol and AlphaGo's match, we've already witnessed AI's remarkable skills. And through its free-thinking abilities, people will be able to enjoy a more convenient life and gain more results with less effort. Of course, there are concerns that AI will steal people's jobs, but many companies are making immense investments in this high-added value field. Korean startups in Silicon Valley are gaining attention with their success. This company, founded by PhD alumni of Stanford University, researches the field of infrared spectroscopy. Every object has a unique spectrum, so this company uses infrared spectroscopy to analyze an object and confirm whether it is genuine or fake. The name of the spectrometer is Link Square. And for now, Link Square will be used to identify genuine and fake drugs.
For example, this is a genuine Viagra. You place it and point it with the Link Square and press scan button in the app. And you can see the genuine Viagra is identified.
This spectrometer can determine the authenticity of a drug and what kind of ingredients are in it. It will not only be commercialized in the biopharmaceutical market, but also be used to detect dangerous objects or foods in various fields.
So we have our own proprietary technology, infrared technology, and it was very good for fit into an IoT space because we can make things smaller and cheaper. So that's why we decided to go into the portable spectrometer market and make it this LinkScare.
This is the spectrometer that can detect infrared light invisible to the human eye. It uses sensors to illuminate an object and capture its spectrum. This technology allows the device to identify almost anything, so it has infinite applications. Existing spectrometers can cost tens of thousands of dollars.
Graph that we measured.
However, LinkScare features the same functions at a fraction of the cost, at around $200 US.
So in the near future, our goal is to get our LinkScare into the hands of pharmacists and care home operatives, even NGOs in the developing world that have a lot of problems with counterfeit drugs. So that's our near-term goal. And our next step after that will be to take our company's other technology, which is our shortwave infrared image sensor, and place it into the LinkScare. And once we're able to do that, we'll be moving into applications related to food.
Countless new businesses open and fail in Silicon Valley. And Korea Innovation Center works to support Korean startups and help them survive.
Technology-wise, the Korean, we are very excellent. But the problem is how to wrap up, how to decorate to make the money, right? That is our weak point. So that is coming from the generating the business model. So we are teaching how to develop the business models very aggressively. So that is very important.
Korea was already the world's most wired country by the 1990s. And with Gangnam's Tehran Valley as their center, many successful venture companies elevated Korea's status as an IT powerhouse. And now the age of ICT convergence has dawned, and Korea built a new nest in Pangyo Techno Valley to incubate new businesses. And like the previous generation, startups are devoting themselves to R&D to become another success story. Pangyo Techno Valley's brightly lit night is steering Korea toward a brighter future.
한국 같은 경우에도 ICT 분야에 굉장히 강점을 가지고 있고, 특히 이 네트워크, 즉 데이터가 많이 생성이 되는 구조로 되어 있는 것이 우리나라가 굉장히 큰 강점입니다. 그래서 향후에도 보면 우리나라 같은 경우에는 데이터를 최대한 많이 생산해서 빨리빨리 유통해서 그걸 가지고 산업을 할 수 있는 그런 데이터에 관련된 분야가 굉장히 유망하다고 말씀을 드릴 수가 있겠고, 데이터를 가지고 인공지능 기술을 활용할 경우에 다른 나라들처럼 플랫폼을 이용을 해서 비즈니스 할 수 있는 기회가 굉장히 많이 있습니다.
Many large Korean companies also incubate startups in various ways, and one of them has set a model example of success. It started out as a small startup in Pangyo Techno Valley and went on to receive the Prime Minister Award this year. This company specializes in smart factories and developed a platform targeting SMEs. Its innovative IoT device WeCon and smart factory platform WinFactory enable SMEs to operate low-cost, high-efficiency smart factories. The company even entered foreign markets with this technology and helped a global sports brand in Qingdao build a smart factory.
Smart factory 플랫폼들이 주로 미국이나 독일에서 성행을 하고 있습니다. 그래서 대부분 글로벌 기업들은 어떤 이제 스마트 팩토리에 관련된 고민을 하면 이제 독일 쪽에 문의를 하거나 확인하는 경우들이 많죠. 근데 이제 어떻게 그런 국가에 비해서는 좀 후발주자이기도 하고, 그다음에 그 후발주자에서도 큰 삼성 같은 큰 기업이 아니라 스타트업을 찾았다라는 것은 굉장히 이례적인 그런 일이 아닌가 하는 생각이 들었죠. 그래서 처음에는 못 믿었습니다.
WIM Factory can be applied to existing production line instead of transforming the entire factory process.
This precision injection molding factory became smart. After installing the platform, its product quality and profits increased due to decreased defect rates. WECON is an IoT device that connects to temperature, humidity, and pressure sensors and transmits the collected data to its cloud server. By combining WECON with cloud, data analysis, and machine learning technologies, the smart factory platform WIM Factory was born. The platform was commercialized after reducing the application cost to 1/10. With WIM Factory, companies can lower their defect rates by monitoring production status in real time and using big data to predict their output and possible malfunctions.
The 공장 같은 경우에는 저희 플랫폼을 도입을 하기 전에는 평균적으로 18% 정도의 불량률이 나왔습니다. 그럼 이제 18%가 그 공장에서 18%가 어느 정도 비용이냐 그러면 한 달에 작게는 3천만 원에서 한 5천만 원 정도를 이제 불량에 의해서 매달 손실이 일어나는 거죠. 근데 저희들 거 플랫폼 적용하고 난 뒤에 3개월 뒤에부터 이제 그 불량률이 줄어들게 된 거죠. 그래서 지금 현재로는 8%에서 10%대 나옵니다. 그래서 반 정도가 축소가 된 건데, 그러면 이제 경제적으로 이제 효율성을 본 거는 거의 1,500만 원에서 2,000만 원 정도의 매달 이제 경제적 이득을 보게 되는 거죠.
As IoT technologies advance further, more companies will switch to smart factories. And using its successful entrance into the Chinese market, this company will head out to the leading nations of the fourth industrial revolution, such as Germany and the US. 3D printing is an important field in the fourth industrial revolution. And there's a startup that's developing a special product with it. Lee Sang-ho is the CEO of a company that makes prostheses using 3D printers. Electronic prostheses tend to be too expensive for low-income people. So Lee developed a way to manufacture affordable electronic prostheses by using 3D printing technology that allows small quantity production.
예전에 불가능했던 제품을 만들어내는 데 좋은 도구가 될 것입니다. 그래서 예전에는 수치 타산이 안 맞아서 못 만들었던 기존 제조업에서는 대량 생산밖에 할 수 없었던 그런 제조업의 한계 때문에 만들지 못했던 제품들이 3D 프린터를 통해서 다품종 소량 생산의 컨셉으로 개인에게 맞춤형으로 제작이 되는 그런 웨어러블 기기 같은 것들 이런 것들의 개발이 매우 쉬워지는 그런 효과가 있기 때문에 이제 앞으로 개인 맞춤형 개인의 삶을 위한 맞춤형 도구 같은 것들을 만들어내는 데 좋은 기술이 되지 않을까 그렇게 생각합니다.
이거는 팔꿈치 뼈 위치를 알기 위해서 제가 부착하는 일종의 마커.
The development of 3D printing technology made it possible for the medical world to not only create skeletal models, but also human tissues and artificial organs. 3D printers will copy any object. When a 3D scanner receives data for the prosthesis, the computer measures, calculates, and completes a 3D blueprint. And once a 3D printer receives that blueprint, it will start printing the designed prosthesis. There is very little room for error, and the manufacturing process is extremely simple. When the printer finishes the product, microcomputers must be installed to act as nerves and muscles. Electronic prostheses amplify weak electric signals sent by human muscles and transmit them to sensors, turning on the electric motor of each finger. The core component is the EMG sensor. It is an expensive part, which explains the high production cost. So Lee developed an EMG sensor at 1/10 of the cost. People who need electronic prostheses can now purchase them for about $1,000 instead of tens of thousands of dollars.
가장 어려운 부분은 어쨌든 저렴한 가격에 만들어야 한다. 이게 가장 어려웠습니다. 그래서 비싼 전자회로나 비싼 센서를 그대로 도입해서 쓸 수 있다고 하면 지금보다 훨씬 빨리 만들었을 거예요. 근데 그렇게 해서는 저희가 목표로 한 100만 원대 전자회수는 만들 수가 없으니까요. 그래서 이 근전도 센서나 이 전자회로 같은 것도 자체 개발을 다 해야 됐고, 그래서 개발하는데 시간이 상당히 많이 소요가 됐고요.
Mr. Lee Jung-hwa lost an arm in an industrial accident. He underwent treatment for an entire year and recently began teaching himself how to live with one hand. To him, this electronic prosthesis is like new life. It will replace his lost arm and bring him new hope. Lee finds beauty in technology that helps people. He started this company because he wanted to use technology in a worthy way. And perhaps this should be the philosophy of countless researchers leading the fourth industrial revolution. How abundant and comfortable can human life get? Evolution of all technologies stemmed from this question. And now, technology has completely changed the paradigm of cities. Sejong Smart City. It's where almost all technologies of the fourth industrial revolution are in use. And they include sensor data collection, cloud, big data, and intelligent surveillance systems. Sejong's U-City Information Center. This place serves as a control center for the entire city. To support crime and disaster prevention, traffic control, and other public services, security devices send all the data to the information center. This allows the control center to monitor everything through surveillance cameras installed throughout the city, detect possible accidents, and other emergency situations.
우리 그 세종시 도시통합정보센터는 현재 그 관제 요원이 총 18명이 근무를 하고 있고요. 그리고 또 저 24시간 근무를 하고 있습니다. 또한 그 CCTV는 현재 그 세종시 전역에 신도시 읍면 지역을 포함해서 총 10여 대가 지금 설치가 되어서 운영을 하고 있습니다.
This smart city's public service even includes the safety of an individual.
세종시 관제사무실 권리입니다. 무엇으로 해야 될까요?
너무 어지럽고 갑자기 가슴이 답답해갖고 너무 힘들어요.
네, 제가 119에 빠른 조치해드릴 거고요. 네.
두남과 연락처 좀 말씀해주실 수 있으세요? 네.
Anyone can ring the bell during an emergency and contact the control center for help. Smart surveillance cameras will also turn toward the person in need and allow the control center to monitor everything in real time. This prevention system has actually saved people from life-threatening situations and even prevented a traffic accident from growing into a big multi-vehicle collision. The surveillance cameras are the eyes that keep the Sejong Smart City safe. This system collects data through IoT, builds big data, analyzes them, and helps the city respond accordingly. A smart city cannot be complete without the convergence of high-tech ICT. Already equipped with the latest ICT, Korea's smart cities will become powerful competitive tools. There is a job that does not even allow a single day off. It's livestock farming. However, the fourth industrial revolution is giving the farmers a well-deserved break. This is a smart cattle farm in Imsil-gun. The cattle are crying loudly for food. It's mealtime, according to the clock. However, the farm owner is still busy in his room, taking his time on a computer.
저희는 스마트 팜이라
이 마우스로 까딱까딱까딱 하면서 손한테 지금 밥을 주고 있는 거예요. 2kg, 2kg 해서 하루 4kg 정도. 이 소들이 먹는 이 사료는 요 하얀 PVC 파이프를 타고 하나, 둘, 셋, 넷 내려가지고 저장이 돼 있고
The IoT sensors control feeding time, auto feeder, temperature, humidity, and other environmental factors, and allow the owner to monitor the animals in real time.
1, 2, 3, 4 이렇게 네 개 정도 카메라가 뭐 여기 지금 소들이 있습니다. 지금 한번 당겨서 볼게요.
Big data collected from all the connected devices are sent to computers and smartphones.
줌으로 당겨 볼게요.
That way the farm owner can look over the farm wherever there is internet connection and remotely control the farm through an app.
소 키운 이후로 하루 이상을 비워본 적이 없는데 스마트 팜을 올해 도입을 하고 해외여행도 갔다 왔습니다. 제가 이 스마트폰을 로밍 해가지고 자, 이 먹는 양을 이렇게 잘 먹고 있는 것도 가서 관찰을 할 수 있었고 또 이 카메라로 각 소들을 다 관찰을 했기 때문에 3박 4일 나가 있는데도 마음이 놓이고 내 눈으로 직접 보니까 아 진짜 스마트팜은 앞으로 이 황폐해가는 우리 농촌에 꼭 도입해야 될 그런 신기술이다 이렇게 생각을 합니다.
Switching over to a smart farm has changed his life. He can now manage his farm easily, form networks with related organizations, and prevent epidemics. Above all, the smart farm has improved the quality of his life by giving him a day off.
Until now, the industry or the competitive advantage of land, labor, and capital has been dependent on it. The future of the industry's competitive advantage is data, AI, 또 창의적인 창의력, 또 다른 나라와 차별화된 기술 등에 의해 가지고 경쟁력이 결정된다고 할 수 있겠습니다. 그래서 저희들은 농업에도 이러한 창의력과 데이터와 클라우드 기술들을 도입을 해서 새로운 스마트팜 시대를 준비하고 있습니다.
Everything is being interconnected. Technologies are advancing at an unprecedented rate and creating equal opportunities for all. To take the lead in this kind of environment, capital and new technologies must converge. We must all advance together because we live in the age of convergence, where resources, technologies, and cooperation must come together to create a finished product. This is the fourth industrial revolution.